Welcome for today's activity, this adventurous new life adventurer club. We are glad to be here today. We have been thinking of this activity today for quite a long time, and we thank God this far we have come. We are a club that is dealing with children ages 4 to 9 years. We have several activities taking place in our club. One of it in the calendar is community service. And this year being COVID-19 pandemic period, we were not able to go out to reach to the families outside there, but we intended to reach the families within us. That is, we are doing inreach today. So we are having our community service today in our church, and we have given several contributions from our club. With the help of our parents and the church community, we have been able to raise the foodstuffs that are here that we are going to distribute to all our members who are within, who are needy, and we can still reach to those without, meaning those who are not members of our New Life Church. I want to welcome all that are going to participate today. We have our very lovely adventurers dressed here in our Class B uniform, which is our t-shirt. And we have also our salutes. You can salute the adventurers. And then we have our staff. We have our adventurer staff. Can you salute? And then together with us, we have also our adventurer parents who are representing the rest of the parents. And we can't do this alone. We are doing it under the deaconate department of our church. So deaconate department, thank you for allowing us to do this together with you. And we have our pastor today here with us. So this is basically what we are doing today. We are doing our community service by doing our inreach through giving. Now, before we begin this exercise, we want to welcome our pastor to give our devotion to at least bless this occasion. Welcome, Pastor.
Thank you so much, our leader, for welcoming me so that we can be able to share a word or two from the Word of God. It is very true that whenever there is an activity that we are undertaking, it's always good to start with devotion. I just want to appreciate the team that they have organized themselves in such a way that they can also join the church, because this is exactly what the church has been doing. Of course, you've not been like doing a separate thing, because you've also participated in what the church has been doing. But in particular, I just want to appreciate you in a very special way, because you found time to ensure that you as a club, because you know those that are needy in this church, that as a club you would touch them. And I believe this will also touch a spirit out there. It could be a parent who is needy. They have the adventurers in the home, and just because of one reason or another, they've not been part of this team. I just want to believe that they'll begin to bring their children, because they can see this act is one that really brings blessings. Allow me to share from the Word of God, and before we do that, let us pray. Father, we thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity you've given us, that we may share your word before we can donate the foodstuffs that are before us. Yes, we know we are hit with COVID, and it has really brought us a lot of losses here and there. People have lost jobs, people have lost their businesses, people are down. But we want to thank you so much for this club that you blessed with parents. Parents who have a big heart to bless those that are needy and those that are less fortunate, that they may share the little that they have with them, that they may show their love, the love that you've also demonstrated to them, that they may equally share with those that are needy. Father, as we share your word, help us to learn more from you, that we may always do what you purpose us to do. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray and believe. Amen. We are going to share from the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, I want to read from verse 27. As Christians, we are taught that it is blessed to give than to receive. And this is exactly what I have noticed with this club, that they are practicing what Jesus really taught us, that we must learn to give, so that then when we give, we are more blessed. I believe once we are blessed, we will keep on giving, and there is no time when we shall lack, because we are practicing exactly what Christianity teaches us. And therefore, as we can be able to read from Proverbs chapter 3 verse 27, the Bible says, "Do not withhold good from those who whom it is due, when it is in your power to act." As Christians, when God has put us in places where we are capable of getting things that we can bless others, it is always a good gesture when we give that which the Lord has given us. It is always good that we can share. Yes, it could be very little, but remember, when we share that little that we have with us, God does his miracle. He keeps on adding it. Remember the widow at Zarephath, and the way the Lord blessed her when the man of God came and he was asking just for a bread. And the lady said, "You know what? This is the only little flour that I have. So we were only going to cook with my son. We eat. And because we couldn't have anything more, once we eat and we are done, then hunger comes, we shall die, and then it is done." But look what happened to this woman. God blessed her more and more. The power that she had was only to prepare that little flour, make the first bread, and share with the man of God. And when she did that, she never lacked flour in all her life. I just want to remind us, brethren and parents, what you have done, it could be that you gave out of a strenuous experience, having a financial constraint. But believe you me, God is so much faithful that in as much as you gave it with all your heart, because God also teaches us that we should give with all our heart, not out of like somebody's pushing you. I believe our leader, Ruth Kebata, has not forced you, neither has she pushed you. She requested that we have noticed that there are needy cases amongst us, and you came up and you supported. We do not take it this for granted. And because you blessed those that are going to be blessed today, within the power that God has put you, I believe God will still continue to hurt you more and more. And so my prayer is that, because this is the spirit, that we may share whatever the Lord has blessed us with, may we continually share more and more, as long as God enables us. And because he has granted us an enabling environment, let's pick it up and go with it. As we bless those souls, we will see what the Lord will do. He will do wonders for us, and will never, ever, ever live in want or in anything like we are lacking anything, because God is faithful. Let us pray. Father, we thank you again for teaching us that we can share with those that are needy, as long as it is within our power. We pray that may you continue to bless us more and more, that we'll have even plenty to bless others, and that those others may as well be able to bless others, and so that the chain may continue like that as we continue to bless with one another. Thank you, because you're a faithful God, and thank you that you can still find a dwelling place deep in our heart, that we can share that which you blessed us with. May you please continue to find a dwelling place in the heart of each and every one of us, that we will continually share with many more, and that we will never tire, that your name may be glorified forever. To this end, we pray that as we come to the end of the prayer, that we may lay the leadership of this club into your able arms. Bless them and continue to grant them more power, ability, and more time to continue to serve you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray and believe. Amen.
We are doing this under a committee which is called Social Community Service Committee, and we have with me here our leader, able leader, Teacher Sandra. I want to welcome her so that she can continue with this particular process.
My name is Sandra, and under the leadership of the director, Ruth Kebati, on behalf of the adventurous parent, I lead the social committee, and this would have not been possible if it were not for our parents. I'm going to introduce our parent, Luke, to go ahead and receive the donations from the on behalf of the other parents who are not able to come because of the situation of the COVID-19. And then he is going to hand over to our able deaconate so that we can continue with this service. May God bless you.
Hi, I'm Luke Osiemo, representing parents of Adventurers. And we are glad and we appreciate the leadership of Adventurers for taking this noble cause to feed the community. And we also urge other parents from other clubs to do the same, because this is what God left us for us in this earth, so that we can reach people through preaching, through giving, and through prayer. May God bless you, and we thank you so much for that. Thank you. On behalf of Adventurers Parents, there are commodities that we bought, and we want to hand them over to the deaconate department. And what we have maize flour, we have sugar, we have beans, and rice, plus oil, cooking oil. So we thank God for this effort that we, our parents, plus the team in charge, has managed to do. And we pray that they may continue with their heart. And we urge both parents from other clubs that let us try our best so that we can reach people through this feeding program. I think that one will go further in this society to help the needy. Thank you so much. Okay, good. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you.
God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you.
That is beans. That is beans. That's rice. This sugar. Oh, take this one. Give this one.
That is sugar.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Adventurer Club, for this honor. We really appreciate you, and we are really thanking God for you. New Life Church has a lot of challenges which has really affected their members and even the outsiders, because we are like a target. So many people come here for support and help, but without such donations and contributions from members, we are unable to reach them. This is really a good honor, and this is a way of really preaching and touching many families that cannot support their needs. The New Life membership formed a COVID committee, which is headed by a church elder, Elder Chuka, and assisted by the welfare leader, Gladys Njuguna. And the coordination is done through the deaconate. We, at any given time, we distribute food to about 180 families. I want to believe that what we have before us today will really touch so many families. As you can see, people are really thronging in, and we just want to start distributing. We really want to pray and reach out to any other organization within the church to do the same. Let us emulate what the adventurers have done, and let us really pray for them so that they should not end there. They can continue with the same spirit. Otherwise, may God bless you, and may really God touch your hearts. Thank you for this wonderful work.
Amen. Let us pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, again we bow before thee. We thank you so much for this ministry that the Adventurers Club have embraced with all their heart. In a very special way, I want to dedicate them before thy throne of grace, that they kindly please the leadership, the parents, the unity that they have had, that you still continue to grant them more and more unity, so that as they are united, they may do a lot more as they bless your children, and especially those that are very needy within us and from without. In a very special way, we want also to commit the whole church into your able arms. We want to pray that, Father, just like the way the church has been doing, that may we also continually do this to bless many other souls. And also to bless the other and the rest of the other clubs and the departments into your able arms, that they may as well come up and do such deeds, such acts of blessings to many others, that gracious dear Heavenly Father, as they work together with the church, that we may all of us appreciate that you've really blessed us to bless many others. Thank you because you're a faithful God. May we never lack. May we never miss to have enough that we can be able to share with others. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray and believe.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.